Hello, Stefan here with Liquidity with a video on the topic of the arguably overused and Swiss Army knife of German verbs, machen.
Liquidity.
I hope you will find this video enjoyable and useful. If you do, please give it a like and check out my other videos on my channel. If you like them, consider subscribing to my channel, please. Perhaps no other verb in the German language is used as much and is as versatile as the verb machen. The German verb machen has an English cognate and practical synonym in the verb to make. However, the German verb machen is used more commonly and is applied in so many more situations and circumstances. It is unthinkable for Germans to have a conversation or any lengthy conversation without the verb machen. That's how essential it is. The German verb machen, similar to the English verb to make, but to a large extent, has a range of meanings and applications. It can mean anything from fabricating something, producing something, to simply just doing something. And very commonly, Germans have a choice whether they want to use the verb tun, to do, or machen, to make. So the two very frequent questions, was machen wir jetzt, or was tun wir jetzt, may be used interchangeably. The verb machen adds a connotation of work and process that the verb tun, to do, lacks. It also implies a certain commitment. So machen tends to be more involved than tun. Machen is used for cleaning, for maintenance, but not just one specific item, but basically the whole process. To take care of is another English expression that very often is best used to translate when a German would say machen. The command form of machen, mach in the singular, or macht in the plural for the regular you, or machen Sie in the formal you form, is used quite often in all kinds of different situations. I can add little particle words like mal and doch to emphasize that this really needs to be done, or that I feel strongly about this being done. So I can say things like mach mal. Mach doch mal, which is a little bit stronger, or really strong if I'm really frustrated and I feel like this really needs to be done now. Mach doch jetzt mal. Go ahead and do this now. Don't wait. Don't hesitate. Don't delay. Don't procrastinate. So mach or macht, if it's several people, mach mal, mach doch mal, and mach doch mal jetzt. Those are very, very commonly used, and you will hear those commonly used by German speakers. Another way in which machen is used is to express that it's not a big deal, or something was really not something to worry about. So for instance, I could say, oh, das macht nichts. Das macht nichts. Literally, that means that makes not or nothing. But it doesn't translate literally. It really means like, no worries, don't worry about it. This did not cause any harm, or this did not affect anyone in any serious way. It did not affect me in any serious way. Don't worry about it. Das macht nichts. Or shortened, sometimes you will hear, oh, macht nichts, macht nichts. Many household chores and also personal care procedures can be expressed with the word machen, or with a separable prefix verb or an idiomatic expression that includes the verb machen. So for instance, we have die Betten machen, to make the beds, die Böden machen, to clean the floors, to take care of the floors, if you will, die Wäsche machen, to take care of laundry, to do the laundry, not just to wash it, but to do the whole process, basically, from sorting it, to washing it, drying it, folding it, possibly even ironing it. And then we have Essen machen. So for instance, I could say, ich mache Abendessen. I'm making dinner. There are quite a few reflexive idiomatic expressions that include the verb machen. For instance, we have ich mache es mir gemütlich, which literally would mean I make it cozy for me. But more aptly translated, it would be I'm getting comfortable, or I'm fashioning for myself a cozy environment and atmosphere. Here's another common reflexive idiomatic expression that can also lead to some confusions. So, sich fertig machen means to prepare yourself. Ich mache mich fertig. I'm getting ready. Maybe I'm getting dressed for the day or something like that. Or I'm, you know, brushing my teeth, taking a shower, get ready for the day. Ich mache mich fertig. If you use that to talk about somebody else, if you, for instance, say, Pauline macht mich fertig, that does not mean that Pauline has prepared me or Pauline is preparing me, but rather in this context, it means that she's destroying me. So maybe Pauline and I have been playing several rounds of poker or chess or whatever game, and she's been beating me every single time. So she's just destroying me. She's obliterating me. So fertig machen has two different meanings depending on the context. Machen is also part of many, many separable prefix verbs. It's the stem of many separable prefix verbs that are used in the German language. To find out more about how separable prefix verbs are used, how they function, please check out my video on that topic. So here are some common examples. Mitmachen. Ich mache mit. I'm joining in. I'm doing whatever you're doing, I'm doing too. Einmachen, which means to actually conserve some vegetables, to can something. Ich mache Tomaten ein. I'm conserving tomatoes by canning them. Anmachen. That one actually has two different meanings. I could say I'm turning something on, like for instance, ich mache die Lampe an. I'm turning the lamp on. It can also mean to be rude to somebody, especially in order to incite a reaction. Peter macht Hans an. That would mean he's being very rude to him. He wants to get a negative reaction from him. Okay, another one is vormachen. Vormachen means to show somebody how to do something, to show by example. Vormachen. So I'm doing it first. Ich mache es vor. And then nachmachen means somebody's actually doing what I just showed them to do. So for instance, I could say, Martin macht mir vor, wie man schwimmt. Martin is showing me how to swim. Ich mache Martin nach, wie man schwimmt. I am following Martin's example of how to swim. Wegmachen. Wegmachen means to remove. Weitermachen. Weitermachen means to continue. Zumachen. To close something. So zu means closed. Zumachen means like to make something closed. To make something shut. So as you can see, there are many, many different applications. These are just some common examples, and you'll probably come across quite a few if you are serious about studying German or if you're around a lot of German speakers. Hopefully this video is helpful for you so that you can follow along a little bit better when people are having conversations, when they're talking about everyday things. One really good thing about machen is that it is conjugated in a very regular way. So for the present tense, we have for the first, second, and third person singular, ich mache, du machst, macht, sie macht, es macht. And then for the plural, we have for the first, second, and third person, wir machen, macht, sie machen. And then the formal you is simply sie machen, has the same format as the they form, and these two are grammatically and historically related, but they're completely different things. We do have a formal you, as many other languages have too. Actually made a video about that. Please check it out if you want to know a little bit more about the difference between du and sie with a capital S, which means formal you. And here's the simple past tense, the preterite. So for the first, second, and third person in the singular, we have ich machte, du machtest, er, sie, es machte. For the plural, first, second, and third person, we have wir machten, ihr machtet, sie machten. And then for the present and past perfect, and actually the present perfect is used very, very commonly in conversations when people just having a conversation, when they're talking to each other, when English speakers would use the simple past tense or the past tense in general. Germans tend to use the present perfect instead. So let me show you these here. For the first, second, and third person, I bunched together the present and past perfect together here. Ich habe oder hatte gemacht. Du hast, du hattest gemacht. Er, sie, es hat gemacht or hatte gemacht. And then for the plural, we have for the first, second, and third person, wir haben, wir hatten gemacht, ihr habt gemacht, ihr hattet gemacht, sie haben gemacht, sie hatten gemacht. And then again, for the formal you, we have the capital Z, the capital SZ, and that has the same format or has the same form as the they form, but it means you have made or you had made. Thanks for watching. Danke fürs Zuschauen. Mach's gut. Take care. Tschüss. Bye. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you enjoy my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Bye.